And we're back for more Mass Effect 2. Pretty sure we're done with this, we're done with the Hoplos system. I'm pretty sure we're done with the entire Hades Nexus at this point. We are, so let's head back to the Mass Relay. Just did another Firewalker episode, or mission, last episode. It was a lot of fun. I hate how you can't save in the middle, but I guess that makes it more challenging, right? Did I get... I only need two, but... might as well. Two probes. Now I'm gonna head back to Omega. Because if I remember right, we never did that... give that guy... his, finished up that quest. I forget his name. Nis or something like that? So, kind of wondering now if this is the last time we have to go to Omega. Well, let's bring Morden. If I do have to come back here again after this, just let me know, guys. Sorry, don't let me know. Do not say, don't spoil any things. hold on a second. My god. Alright, let's give her some slam points. Yeah, that wasn't a Freudian slip, that was just me. Being tired. I'm tired. I work all day and play and upload games all night and... Nis? Liss? Ish! That's his name. Howdy.
Hello again, my friends. Please tell me you have something for me.
Pack from Ilium, the pack is from Citadel, or the stolen data. Am I asking him about the stolen data, or giving him stolen data?
Have you seen what's in these packages?
I'm asking him.
Why? Did you find something untoward? Certainly nothing worth getting worked up about.
You sure this is safe?
This information could weaken Arya's organization. You better be sure it's safe before you take it anywhere.
I'm touched. Trust me, I know what I'm doing.
He's been doing this a long time.
What are you after?
Why do you want information about one of Arya's men?
It's not for me. A lot of people want to leg up on Arya, and they'll pay a lot of credits to get it. If Anto or Arya found out, I'd be ruined. Or killed.
I'm listening to the... and the background. It's so funny. By choosing this, am I not completing the mission, not handing it over to him? I guess so. It should be interesting anyway. Give it up, Ish.
Arya will find out what you're up to, Ish. I don't envy you when that happens.
I think I can handle it.
Huh. No one has beaten Arya in centuries.
Stuttering?
Once she casts down your client, she'll come looking for you.
You're right. I have to get out of here.
Huh.
Thank you, my friend. You probably just saved my life. Come on, Sal. We have to get out of here.
Bye, Ish. Hope you get rather, you know, go around, go away rather far-ish. Right, we talked to her last episode, Tally. Travel to the Migrant Fleet's current location, Raheel Leia, with Cloggin in the Valian Valhalla Threshold. This is weird, but I want to finish up the Firewalker thing. I've been going for so long. So what happened? This is still here. It's not completed. Both packages have been delivered. Did I give it to him then? Then why isn't it not in finished assignments? Should I go? Something's telling me, what if I go talk to Aria about it? Let me just go check with her before I leave here. I mean, maybe I have to leave the place before the mission's done. This game's kind of funny like that, but let me see if there's any option to tell her about it.
What do you need?
Evidently nothing.
Thanks. Maybe I'll come back later. You should find a nice young man to keep you warm in the meantime.
You really gotta stop. You really gotta stop saying that. I'm getting better looking. You're right. You're absolutely right. Even though I walk, or I run, rather, with a limp. Jogging's fine, as long as I don't run. Then my bum leg starts to reveal itself. Alright, let's get out of here. Now I want to see if this quest disappears off my quest log. It's still there. What? Well, he left, so I don't know if this thing's ever gonna go off my thing. Maybe I have to check messages first. Messages? No? No messages? You tell me, I'm just checking. Nope. Alright, I don't know. I don't know what the deal is with that. I was gonna head to another system that has firewalker stuff in it. Am I full of stuff? Where's the fuel depot right here? It's a very busy system. Alright. Yeah. I had their last, actually. Because that's Overlord. I'll start that next. Or at some point. Yeah, I'll probably do it next. So the Hawking Eta, which is, apart from the local cluster, is the only cluster I can remember here being in the first game. I mean, maybe Hourglass Nebula? Crescent Nebula? I'm not even sure. I know most of these are new. So anyway, Hawking Eta. Engage. Firewalkers in the next one. Chandra Sakar system. The planet Teshub. The first and larger of the two gas giants in the Hawking Eta gateway system, Teshub is composed mainly of hydrogen and helium. The brown and orange coloration in its upper cloud decks are caused by the upwelling of sulfur from lower levels of the atmosphere. Moderate. Again, even with that upgrade we did, we're still above 100,000 on everything but the EZO. So let me just look for a little EZO really quick. Evidently there is none. I don't want to launch a probe, game. Leave me alone. Okay. That's the mass relay, okay. So there is only two planets. Two gas giants and two planets total. Hebat. Hebat is a methane ammonia ice giant. When heavy metals exo-mining of China won the bidding rights to develop the moon of Presrop in the Century system, it began by establishing helium-3 refueling facilities on Hebat. You gotta make facilities plural, that's the only way that sentence makes sense. The station, completed this year, is considered a model facility by the executives of the state-run company. Though the station produces more than enough fuel to supply the HMEC systems running to and from Sentry, it has a crew of only a dozen for maintenance and oversight. Nearly all the day-to-day operations are automated. Moderate results. Hold on, guys. I feel like I have to sneeze. And I sneezed. Thank you. Nothing else. Okay. Let's go to a Sentry system first. A whole bunch of systems here. Very big system. Spread out. Let's see what we got in here. Tamahara. Tamahara has a thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide and xenon. The surface is icy and composed of sodium oxide with deposits of calcium. It contains a few unremarkable metals, but mainly consists of rock. The presence of canyons and floodplains indicates that liquid water once existed, suggesting Tamahara had a thicker insulating atmosphere in the past. In resources. Checking for Ezo. Yeah, it's got plenty of crap here for you guys. If any of you are looking for a good planet. As for me, I just find it myself. That's half the fun. Unfortunately, I don't need any of it. We have to be, like, more than halfway done with upgrades. Like, ever. In this game, anyway. Clendagon. Clendagon is an arid terrestrial, slightly larger than Earth, but with a lower density that reflects its relative lack of heavier elements. The crust is composed of tin and aluminum, with wide deserts of dust-fine sand that are easily stirred by the wind. Clendagon's most striking feature is the Great Rift Valley that stretches across the southern hemisphere. What is most fascinating about the rift is that it does not appear to be natural. The geological record suggests it is the result of a glancing blow by a mass accelerator round of unimaginable destructive power. This occurred some 37 million years ago, excuse me. Rich in stuff. See, sometimes when I see it go into it, you think you might get a little Ezo. But it'll be such a small amount if we do. Yeah, no. Next up, Cantra. A terrestrial world of average size, Cantra's atmosphere composed of nitrogen and argon. is composed of nitrogen and argon. Its frozen surface is mainly composed of tin with deposits of calcium. Aside from some spectacular formations of water ice at the poles, the planet has little to recommend it. I'll be the judge of that. I mean, if you're looking for these things, then yeah, I'd recommend it. But I am not. Good enough. Fourth planet. Therapto. Therapto is a typical ice gas giant with traces of chlorine and sulfur in its atmosphere. It has over 100 moons and an extensive ring system composed of pulverized rock, presumably the debris from shattered moons. Anything? 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 Bueller? Bueller. Nope. Wow, so that's this entire system. Nothing here. Just stuff, planets to look at. That's cool, though. There's a weird sound at the end when we zoomed out. Did you hear that? That was weird. Let's fuel up. Head on to Schwarzschild. Apparently four planets. That's a very hot looking sun. Atahil? A typical Venusian greenhouse world, Atahil is only of note for a few scattered craters. Though flattened by millions of years of high pressure, the marks of orbital bombardment strikes are unmistakable. It is generally accepted among academics that whoever hailed from or settled Schwarzschild's second planet, Etemis, must have had outposts on Atahil as well. So here. So I like we're like ripping through these systems, I feel like. Pretty cool. Feel like, you know, making progress. Not that I'm hasty for the game to end, it's just I feel like we have so much more to do. Alright. Second planet, is that Etemis? Etemis is a terrestrial world, a third larger than Earth. It is in a post-garden state that clearly shows evidence of attack from space. While now waterless, the shores of former oceans show patterns of cratering too regular to be anything but saturation bombardment by dreadnought-class kinetic weapons. Although it is unclear how, most of the atmosphere has been lost. Archaeologists have found little of note. It appears that all settled regions were touched by the global bombardment. The few relics found suggest an advanced spacefaring culture thrived on the world somewhere between 20 and 40 million years ago. The level of antiquity makes it impossible to estimate the world's former population or guess whether it was the race's homeworld or a colony. Stuff. Very cold. Very high gravity. Heavy gravity going on. Look what we found! We found something awesome. Even better.
Launching probe.
Nice. Did we find any more? Oh yeah! Cool.
Launching probe.
Nice. Azo mining for me.
Probe launched.
Look how much we got, wow.
Probe launched.
I believe the Azo we had was like always in the teens, like we're struggling just to keep it up at 20,000. Now we're double that. That's awesome.
Launching probe.
Over 40K.
Away.
Probe the crap out of it. Cool, cool. Try to get as high as we can. That looks like
launching probe.
That is the best spot right there. Just double checking for any more. Okay. Atemis, or Atemis, ladies and gentlemen. Pretty. Lanasa, or Lanosa. Lanosa is a hydrogen helium gas giant. It is surrounded by several thin rings of debris. Analysis of this debris has been difficult due to its extreme age and fragility, but several apparently nano-manufactured materials have been identified. The leading theory is that the inhabitants of Atemis mined the atmosphere for helium-3. Well, we're not looking for helium-3. Let's see if there's any... element zero at all. Maybe trace amounts, but that's it. Well, it looks like this episode's just gonna be all planet mining, guys. Or probing, what have you. Hope you guys don't mind. Final planet. Rahali. Rahali is a typical hydrogen helium gas giant. It is notable because none of its moons is larger than 12 kilometers in diameter, a rare trait among the charted gas planets of the galaxy. That's pretty tiny. Tiny little moons. Drive around them. Like in an hour or less. Yeah, so no surprises on these planets. No random people with, you know, need to be rescued or distress signals or abandoned equipment, that kind of thing. Done. Dishway, dishway. Keep stopping. refuel. Couple probes. Let's head for Ver. There's Koring artifact collection, and there's two other planets. Alusa. Alusa is a small, dense ice giant with high concentrations of water, ammonia, and methane. A few automated helium-3 stations have been established to refuel the ore freighters shuttling to and from Koring. There's an awful lot of gas giants in this cluster. They love that helium-3. Anything? Nothing. Nada. Another gas giant? Sareo. Sareo is a standard hydrogen-helium gas giant. Its most obvious features are a pair of gigantic storm cells, one in the northern hemisphere and one in the south. While richer in helium-3 than Alusa, the difficulties of extraction from Sareo's gravity well and stormy atmosphere led to the other gas giant's development. Sareo has over 80 moons, ranging from a radius of 50 to 2,000 kilometers. The Asari Tersicore Council has established an observation post on one of the larger moons to study the planet's twin storm systems. Poor results. Whee. This one. Yeah, we're a half hour in. I'm not gonna go to this planet, this, you know, land, but I'm checking out.
I have detected an anomaly.
Initial surveys of Koring noted its high density and active plate tectonics, suggesting a high internal heat fueled by a greater than normal concentration of heavy elements and radioactives. Early test cores proved the mineral richness of the world, but distance from the mass relay in the Century system made it unprofitable to develop into late 2183. The atmosphere is a smog of methane, ammonia, and water vapor, a so-called primordial soup. And they spelled primordial wrong. Similar to the conditions of early Earth. However, there is no evidence of life developing on Koring's surface beyond the level of simple dextroamino acids. The minimal energy input of the red dwarfed Ver have created an energy-starved surface environment, though the planet's volcanism does hold some possibility for subterranean development. That's our anomaly for the Firewalker.
Launching probe. I have found something.
Is that your technical diagnosis? Scans have found locations matching the descriptions of Dr. Case's survey sites. Exploring the sites could reveal valuable mission data. Warning, Geth presence detected on planet's surface. Use extreme caution. Let's just finish scanning this first. Gonna fight some Geth with the hammerhead thing. There's really high levels of other stuff, but no element zero that I can see. Okay, so stay tuned for next episode when we land on the surface and fight the Geth with the Fireworker hammerhead vehicle type thing. Thanks for watching. See you next time and endure. In enduring, grow strong. Stretch that back. What the hell's over there? What's there?